No, no, if it was, like, if it was her. For example, there's two dogs. So did I, but somebody, there was a family that was supposed to be coming for Pablo, there was another couple that was supposed to be coming to foster for Sweetpea, and another couple, but they're not supposed to be coming to work on Thursday, so they may still be coming. So I'm hoping that nothing else comes for you, the other two parties haven't contacted me. But in anticipation of Sweetpea.
Well, you get the papers, once you get them.
So if it's a dog that I know.
Both ways.
Home with somebody, yeah, we are missed, I'll have to report it back and have our official hearing actually happen at those.
There you go. Very good.
Yeah, so she just holds out, she goes, and eh, don't feel sorry for me, don't you need to be cooking. And that's exactly what happens.
Yeah.
They think she's about five.
It's a German, right?
She's a German Shepherd mix. She's mixed with something, we're not sure exactly what.
Hi, pretty girl.
I feel like she's, I think she's kind of gotten a little depressed in the, you know, the amount of time that she's been at the shelter. Yeah. That's why I'm so surprised that no one came for her. Like, yeah. It's just, it's a little strange. Yeah, well, and for her, because she was speaking out before, they had heard from her previous adopters were, and they tried to contact her, and there's been no return. So what they do is when they scan and there's a chip and it's registered, the first thing they do is they call the numbers that are listed. Then they try to send an email, and then that same day that the dog arrives, they put a letter in the mail. So there's three ways that they try to contact, and it's shocking how many dogs and cats come from that shelter that are chipped that don't get home because of people. They don't register them. They got a microchip 8 years ago, and they moved three times, and they changed their pet number, and they haven't updated anything. So if you can't get a hold of them, what do you do? You know, there's a couple of staff members and a whole army of volunteers that try and they keep tabs on all of the next door pages, all the lost and found pages on Facebook, and they try and match up descriptions and pictures of dogs with. You know, they just go right through the whole list of dogs that come in. But there's weeks where there's 120 dogs that come in the space of 3 days. How do you keep up with that? Wow. Like, it's insane.
Good.
Exactly. I would, like, turn Pima County upside down. They get so sick of seeing me at that.
I know.
They're like, what, do you work here again? Do you ever go home? Don't your other dogs miss you? Yeah. There's so many different pages just for dogs here in the county. There's so many lost and found pages. But then there's people that just, and then there's also people that find out that the dog's there, like Rambo's owners knew that he was there. They stopped, they cut off all contact with PACC. They blocked PACC's number, and they never came for him. All they had to do was answer the phone.
Whoop.
And say, not coming for him. They could have released him because it's on a recorded line. So that counts as being done just as much as in writing. The staff makes a notation, spoke to so-and-so at such and such a time on this extension number, so that there's a record of it, and then if you ever has to get pulled, it's all in the recordings, they have all that. So you can verbally relinquish on the phone. And I used to have, as the doctor's coordinator, I used to have those conversations with people all the time, like, listen, sir, tonight is the last night for your dog to be on hold. I have a family here that wants to take the dog home and give him a loving home. If you're not going to come in before 7 p.m. tonight, will you please relinquish ownership to me right now?
Yeah.
And I will let these people take the dog home and give them a good home.
Yeah.
And when I explained it that way, I think I had one guy that's like, nope, he can sit there and rot until tomorrow. Mm. I'm like, okay. So that guy, I was so pissed. I'm like, there's no way in hell I'm going to let this dog stay here. So I said to the couple, I said, we close in 6 minutes. Can you wait until 7:01? And then this is why 7:01 is because at 7 o'clock he becomes my property. He becomes Pima County property. And if you are willing to wait until it's 7:01 on my computer, I will process his adoption right now. So that's what we did. We had everything done, and I waited to hit the last thing until it was 7:01. The guy showed up the next day, and they're like, sorry, the dog's already been adopted.
There you go.
Well, that's how I feel about it. It depends on the circumstances. It's not easy to put somebody on a dog list. I mean, it's an easy process, but it's not. They have parameters.
There you go. Oh.
Yeah, no, the shelter didn't name him. That was what was listed on the
back. Here.
You're back. I remember the
container.
Yeah, we don't know. We didn't name her that. She came in with that from the shelter. So
yeah.
She's 90. Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Old?
They think she's about 5.
Yeah.
She needs to lose probably a good 15 pounds.
Yeah.
Or be that healthy range.
Is it a full German Shepherd?
No, she's a mix with something. This is actually what she was talking about.
Oh, good.
Mm-hmm. So,
look at
those ears.
Yeah, but we're not exactly sure what she's a mix of. But so this was her first picture. That was what she was at PACC.
You're right. I do see the
Corgi.
Do
you see? Yeah.
Corgi.
Yeah, right. Corgi. Yeah, right. And then you see her size, and that's what throws you. But I think Kaylin's the one who said that, and I think she might be right.
Yeah.
I just hope that Mom was the shepherd. That's all I'm hoping.
Yes.
But then that was yesterday's picture. Or that was Friday's picture. This was yesterday.
Turned out to be really, really well.
Oh.
So we can't really figure it out. But to give you an idea,
Yeah, and I have, the other dog is my area, I've been there doing it for 40 years. I was into Irish setters raising them. We go to the Airedales and, the dog could be too small for the size, we had one last year. But don't get it, that was what I'm saying. We got, well, we gotta get a mid-sized dog, and so we got, you know, we're got, it had to be five in my area. So we were there. If he's a little, that's okay, we don't.
Yeah, I think she's, because I said she's very strong.
Whatever.
Whatever. For the young one.
Yeah.
We love that dog.
Oh, well, he sure lucked out.
Yeah, we got lucky too, he's a real.
Sparks all the dogs, so she probably exhausts herself.
He knows how to smile.
No.
No, she's, I think she's got her stuff coming up here, she's nice and relaxed.
And we just wonder what she was doing. They did run 45, but they pulled most of it.
Peter?
Yeah, so who knows what was happening.
So, I just, you wonder if someone was, we wanted to come out here, you know. So they did.
I don't think he'd be upset with this one.
Peter?
Because they kind of get them.
Peter, give us me.
You want to bring part of the water.
Oh, okay.
We break down the dogs and.
Wow.
Sometimes we get everything with dogs and they just.
Well, it's, you know, it's tough when they're rescued because you just don't know where they've been and what's happened.
Right, yeah, I'm used to picking, you know, buying.
Yeah. It's a different, it's a different scenario, but.
Yeah, we got, we got it, it was important.
Yeah, yeah. This one is where it has snoring.
And we're glad we did, we got them all with us.
Yeah, well, that's great, yeah.
No, she's kind of a nice mix of.
But they all do well together, they all very.
Being a shepherd and whatever else.
See this one?
Well, good luck on this. I'm so happy to see you all here.
Yeah.
Good, man, she meet me.
This would I help her walk good.
Yeah, we just walked.
She's a big girl, she weighs 100 pounds.
What I understand is, she's acting like she just lived in a bad yard. So she's really not.
Wait, you have to.
Really, you know, walking on a leash, I mean, she does it, but.
It's a little natural.
Doesn't seem a little bit anxious, she's been a little bit anxious here.
We've seen that, we saw, we found a. We almost just kept.
This game is the higher.
Yeah.
What it was a daughter, who was working to give it to the average person. And they weren't watching, they were not curious, and so the poor thing got out.
Yeah. No, and she doesn't, because here she doesn't tell you.
Right, right. Yeah.
She was well cared for wherever she came from.
Oh, I'll tell you, here and other places.
These dogs are all from here. We partner with the animal care.
They're so sweet.
And they just come up basically.
This one's hacking me up, she's snoring so loud.
The hopes that we're going to find adopters or fosters for them.
Take care.
And then.
Yeah, take care of yourself, thanks for coming in.
So they would like to call care.
Yeah.
Being at that noisy, you know, chaotic shelter, so. A lot of them do just this, they come up and they just sleep on it.
You know, when I first saw this, she was brown, I thought that's weird. And then I realized it was getting beautiful.
Yeah, it was, yeah,
it was very rhythmic and it was getting louder and louder.
You know, I love when they come up and they snore here, because you never hear dogs snore at the shelter. They don't get that relaxed,
right.
And they don't get into that deep of a sleep. So when they can come up here and relax to that level, that's
cool. Like the one I'm working.
Really cool to see.
Holy, she's funny.
She's got so much personality. This is great, because we were walking and it was fine, but you know, the anxiety was pretty high.
Yeah.
And so.
Yeah, my phone.
Anyway.
Hey, Pablo. What's that?
It's low now.
Pablo. Luna snores, Brian.
He knows that he's in this one.
Yeah, just stop. That would be really loud.
them paws out and she's just goofy. She's like goofy girl. And she's not on any medication or anything like that.
I think myself dead.
So she's a good girl. Since she's just waking up, would you be okay?